And now all of the warm-ups are done. As we get into the rolls.
Oh no! Nah, never mind. Oh no. No, no, no. You can't be rolling a one. This is your loser's bracket round of 32. And you roll a one? No, no, no.
Oh man. So the pick is gonna go over to the side of Goku for their pick. So, Celerant is asking if they can go second band, second pick. Unfortunately, they cannot pick both. So, they would have to pick second band or second pick and hope the other team chooses first for the other one. Oh man, we don't get to choose pick band order. No, you get to choose either the pick order or the band order. The other team gets to choose the other one. So it looks like Celerant's team Goku is going to be choosing second pick, which means that Team Game Enjoyers gets to choose if they want first or second band. In these situations, you almost always want to choose second band. Second band is always good because at this skill level, most players are going to have trouble on the same exact type of maps. They're going to be either the Hard Rocks, the Hidden 2 especially, and then possibly one of the DTs. And if everybody has those types of difficulties on those maps, there's a non-zero chance that the other team will ban it for you. So it's always good to have second ban, as Nah Nevermind, or I'm just going to be calling him Nah, as Nah goes and chooses second ban. Smart decision by him. As we get into the bans, what will Team Goku ban? Team Goku Giga Chad not going to be banning the Hidden 2, hopefully. Please don't ban the Hidden 2. I love the song. Please don't ban it. Don't be the team that does the Hidden 2 ban. Ban something interesting like Nomad 5 or a free mod. Nomad 3 ban, let's go. As much as I love Fallout Boy, this is a very good ban. Now let's see what the Game Enjoyers ban will be. And you see the Hard Rock 2 ban. Nobody likes tequila at this age. You're all underage. You can't be drinking tequila anyways. As we now get into the match, it is Game Enjoyers' first pitch. As we see the Nomad 2 pick. This is going to be Suzaku versus Genbu Himiko, another by Maddie, picked by the Game Enjoyers. Nomad 2s are almost always going to be your generic stream map. And this map is no different. We'll get lots of streams and bursts followed by some buzz sliders into even more streams. It is a very good Nomad 2 that our map pool team has selected this time. As of right now, it looks like the teams are going to be Celerant and Cheems on the side of Goku, Na and AK on the side of Game Enjoyers. And it looks like Ayudame Porfa is coming in for Goku. I wonder if Ayudame Porfa has a friend named Vore. As we see AK in the chat going shh 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 shh, followed up by a grinning guy in sunglasses. As we see Ayudame putting in the good luck, so the match will be beginning in about 10 seconds. As we get into the match, this is going to be point one for the match of Game Enjoyers versus Goku in the loser's bracket, round of 32. As we see the first break coming very early from the side of Ayudame Porfa and Team Goku. And just looking at this very beginning sections, you can easily tell which team picked this as their first map. As I say that, Na and Celerant go and break at the exact same note. AK coming in and breaking as well. This is getting very interesting. The only high combo now on the field is from Ayudame Porfa. And the score goes over to the side of Goku right now. Looks like Nevermind actually was a slider break, which is so unfortunate. AK just not having a fun time on the accuracy side. 87 accuracy, we have a 99 from Nevermind. 91 and a 97 on the side of Goku. But with that 450 combo, it's going to be coming in clutch so hard. This score is just inching forward and forward. AK finds another break. That's not good if you want your team, Game Enjoyers, to win. You do see a break coming from Solarin, but Ayudame with that 670 combo just looks like this is a done deal for this map. It would have to be a miracle chain miss from Ayudame and a miss from Solarin to even have even a thought of the comeback. As I do say that, Ayudame does break, but there's just no time left in this map. And as we go into the final 5 seconds of the map, it looks like this is going to be point one for Team Goku as we get into this last spinner. There's going to be 1 point to Team Goku, and it is now Team Goku's pick. That looks like it's going to be a Nomad 1 pick coming out from the side of Team Goku. It might have been just a very quick pick for them, just so that they didn't lose the pick, because it sounded like time was getting really close. Either that, or it's just a comfort pick, you know, going for that consistency. And although it is a Nomad 1, you know, the song category known for the sleepers, I've had this song stuck in my head all day. So it does get very, very addicting to listen to. As it looks like we have Chiems and Mateoki. I don't know how to say his name. I'm gonna ping the referee to see if they can ask. As we get into the Nomad 1, and already we do see a break from Chiems. Accuracy Gamers over here though, keeping it close. as it looks like that break was in the very first, like, 40 notes of the song, so it's not gonna really mean much in the real thick of things. As we do, oh, there's a break from AK on the beginning of this slider section for the PI. We get into this, the very first jump section. Everybody ends up hitting it. But that miss is so... It's not late into the map, but it's a Nomad 1, so every miss is really gonna hurt your team if the other one is really good at consistency. We see a 99% accuracy from Cheems, and almost a 98 from Monte Aqui. 99.7 sitting on the side of Nevermind. Nah, Nevermind. It's just that one miss coming out from AK is really so unfortunate. If we get into the, right past the halfway point in the map, getting into two-thirds of the way down. Oh, we see a miss from Nah, and a miss from Cheems, though. If we see a miss from Monte Aqui, this does get interesting. But he's just so... He's holding on so perfectly right now that doesn't look shaky at all. Cheems does find another break. But hold on a second, the points are leading over. AK's recovered his accuracy. Oh, and right before, Monte Aqui must have missed. I must have not seen that. That changes things. The highest combo in the match right now is from AK with the 650. And the points slide over to the side of Game Joy's. Cheems finds another miss. That's not what you want to see. Gosh, if I would have seen that one miss from Monte Aqui, this would have been such a different story for this casting. I'm just so shook that I didn't see it. We see more misses from Cheems. AK and Nah Nevermind are just holding on so nicely right now. And it looks like it's going to be break point for the side of Game Enjoyers. Just a break point back to back. Great recovery from AK after that early miss. Nah, never mind having another slider break issue. Same with Monte Aqui. But it is 1-1, each team winning their opponent's point. Very, very close. It is going to be next pick Game Enjoyers. I wonder what they will go for. Not really well versed on either of these teams, so it'll be interesting to see how picks go. Looks like they're taking all the time up on the board to, I don't like to use the word stall, but it looks like they are,
taking things leisurely, let's say. Well, it looks like they're going to be picking DT1, a whole new world god. Gonna be Nah, Nevermind, and AK alongside of Game Enjoyers on Goku, Team Goku. It's gonna be Ayudame, Porfi, and Matsuyaki. This is such a close match. You don't want to be in either team's shoes because any score can score leak can just vanish if you miss. You have no room for error. AK finds the break. That's not what you want to be seeing. That score is going to start leaning over. Ayudame finds another break. AK trades it back. The only combos left on the board are from Nah, Nevermind and Matsuyaki. But Nah, Nevermind has a 250 combo going into this very fast, the very last section. Score is so close, it can switch anywhere. Matsuyaki finally going over that 200 combo. Nah, Nevermind has about an 80 combo lead over him going into this final single tap section. And
it looks like the lead is going to go over to the side of Game Enjoyers for this pick. An 88,000 point difference. That is such a close margin of error, especially on a DT like this. Very well put up scores by everybody. And the point goes 2-1 in the favor of Game Enjoyers. This will be interesting, though. I am not familiar with if any of these players are good at low AR hidden. But seeing that Team Goku picked it, I'm going to guess that they feel slightly more comfortable than Game Enjoyers. The main appeal of this map is going to be the longer sort of AR8 streams that are very easy to follow along with, but also the diamond jumps at the very first third and second third part of the maps. Those can really be combo breakers, as we see the good luck platforms coming through for everybody. As we are getting into the map, right about now. Maybe now. Come on. Everybody's already said good luck. Come on. Hello. Is anybody out there? We already have good looks coming out. Something in the, our streamer's cooking some food right now. Ah, there's the match. Okay. It was just taking a second to load. We see the very first break coming up from the side of AK. Must have just misread one of the doubles, or one of the triples as a double. So it's very easy to do on this map for those perfect stacks. As we see more breaks coming up from AK, We do see Ayudame Porfa break on the one diamond jump, AK breaking again. And it's just an accuracy difference. Accuracy deficit is so huge. Now, never mind with a 98. And the only other combo that matches his is from an 88% accuracy FC from Mate Aqui. This lead is just growing. Nah, never mind though, finds the break. That's massive for the side of Goku. Because while Mate Aqui only has an 88% accuracy FC, it's an FC nonetheless. Ayudame does find a break though to trade with Nah, never mind though. And the only combos left are from AK, and now not even Mate Aqui's FC. AK is the only one with any combo on the field. But he finds the break as well! It's going to be a 150k lead for the side of Game Enjoyers. Going into the final 30 seconds of this map, I don't think that Team Goku has enough map to be able to pull anything lead or back. But even if they did, the accuracy in the combo on the side of Nevermind just trumps anything that the other team would have to combat it. And this score is only going to keep getting larger and larger. AK and Ayudame finding breaks at the very end, just as Mate Aqui does as well. And that is going to be about a 230,000 difference. Kazu Tree, yes, I was in six-digit state cup. I was from Team Colorado. And I totally get that. You took the words right out of my mouth with big ACK advantage. Nah, never mind, the 97.76 combating, I think that was an 88, 87% accuracy from the side of Mate Aqui. There it is. That's the thing I'm looking for. And that's for the wrong match. Let me quickly go find the one for the correct match. What match is it? Goku versus Game Enjoyers. Okay, here we are. And there's the MP link. That is the correct MP link that we're looking for. There's an 88% accuracy for Mate Aqui. And it looks like the side of Game Enjoyers are going to choose Nomad 5. So this is the first time that I've seen this map being picked in this, or at least when I'm refereeing. So it'll be interesting to see how this goes. I'm not much of a Nomad 5 player, so, and you know, you can't really, you know, the joke is that you can never pool speed for low digits and low star rating. So I'm going to be expecting, you know, some quick bursts, some buzz sliders. 2 minutes to pick. Is that allowed? Yes. The time limit to pick a map is 2 minutes exactly. The command that all the refs use is IMP, or exclamation point, MP timer 120. So they get exactly 120 seconds to pick a map, and during that time they can do whatever they want. As we see the good luck have funs coming out from all the players as we get into the map. We get into it for the team of Goku. It's going to be Ayudame, Porfa, and Mate Aokui. To the side of Game Enjoyers, it's going to be Non Neverminded AK. As everybody holds through the beginning of the map, accuracy suffering everywhere, but you know, that's to be expected. The first break coming from AK. It is before the first quarter of the map, though, so hopefully it won't matter much. Ayudame breaking right now, though, that might make a bigger difference, though. The closer it is to the middle of the map, the bigger the difference in the importance of the breaks. Ayudame finding lots of breaks now. This is getting interesting. If I'm hoping for the side of Goku to win this, you know, you gotta hope that he can finally hold on to some combo. The only FCs left from Mate Aokui and Nah Nevermind. So we start getting into the more fast section. Ayudame and Mate Aokui finding the breaks. Ayudame breaking more, Mate Aokui breaking. This is going to be massive for the side of Game Enjoyers with Nah Nevermind holding on to that FC. AK finding break, Ayudame finding a break. Even if AK trades with Ayudame, his teammate Nah Nevermind is carrying their team on the back of his shoulders, carrying that score. Not to say that AK isn't doing very well himself. But Nah Nevermind still holding on to that FC. Both Ayudame, Porfa, and AK finding breaks. Mate Aokui finding some combo, but it's just too late into the map to be able to make up any sort of point deficit. Ayudame and AK having low combos. Mate Aokui finding a break right at the end as well as Ayudame. And that is going to be an... That is going to be a 95% FC from Nah Nevermind. That is one of the lowest FC or accuracies I've seen in a while. But it gets them the point, and now it is a breakpoint for the side of Game Enjoyers. Accuracy is only important when both teams have the same combo. But if one player FCs, it doesn't matter what their combo is, you're going to have to FC to even combat it. And that is what Game Enjoyers has just showed us. 4-1, Game Enjoyers leading Goku. And it is now Goku's pick. And I wonder what it Goku is gonna go for. Their backs are against the wall for this tournament match right now. They would have to win 4 points in a row. Looks like the side of Team Goku is looking over every single possible map that they can try to win. It looks like they're going to go with DT3, Inabakamori, Hellamarina, Resultix, Dim, or Zatlet. That's how you say it. This is going to be very finger control heavy. There's going to be lots of triples and doubles. But knowing some of these players, I'm sure a lot of them will be able to FC it. So it's all about nerves. As we see teams come in for Ayume Porfa. Well, I'm not tired, you're tired. We get into the map. The first break is going to come over from Mateakwi. Accuracy is just so abysmal all on the board. The only good accuracy right now is from Cheems, who is the sole reason that Team Goku is in the lead right now. As we do see Nevermind finding a break right before the first third of the song is done. And this is such a short song, you don't want to be breaking just like Cheems did. AK is the only FC left on the board. Mateakwi with a good combo though, and his accuracy is much better than AK's. We do see a break from Nevermind and Cheems at the exact same time, so it's just going to come down to see if AK can win with the combo, and if Mateakwi can hold on with accuracy. That score lead is going over inch by inch over to the side of Game Enjoyers. So it looks like AK is starting to mellow out around the 91% mark. And this final key eyes section is going to be the entire lead. Mateakwi finds a break on that Buzz Slider. That's not good. Wait, no, it was a Banjo break. He's still up scene. but it just looks like there's not enough unless some actually AK finds a miss. That's huge for the side of Goku. That score swings over to their side. Team's at almost 400 combo. Masai Akui going on to 675. Nah, never mind finds a break. AK finds a break. Nah, never mind finds another break. And that lead just goes right over to the side of Goku. What a very intense last 15 seconds that we just had in this match as the match point goes over to the side of Goku. Great score by Masai Akui. From the side of Game Enjoyers is going to be the hidden one. This is not surprising knowing that their prowess is mostly on consistency maps. We'll just have to see how this leads out. So in for, gosh, it was Masai Akui and there wasn't, who was it in? It was Cheems, that's who it was in for them. But instead of Cheems now, it's going to be Celerant. Everybody's saying their good luck, have funs. And we will see, is this the last match of the game? Or are we going to see if Goku has one more chance to bring it to tiebreaker? to get through this very first intro into the map. We only see one breaking is from the side of AK. This is starting to become a common occurrence as AK will find the very first break, but he is always the one that ends up getting that big combo going into that mid to late map. Ends up pulling his team ahead. So let's see if it's just a break early to not have any nerves. As it looks like their team is going to be leading right now with accuracy lead. As we do see a break from Mateakui from side Goku. Now the only two FCs are going to be from Nevermind and Solarin. I take that back, Solarin just goes and finds the miss. The only FC is from the side of Nevermind. AK and Mateakui finding identical breaks. Nevermind finding a Bansho break. So his real combo is still on that score. But Bansho thinks he missed, which is why his name flashed red. Nevermind coming up onto the 500D or 550 combo. That lead is about 160,000 right now. And it looks like AK has got some backing combo now. But unless we see a miss from Nevermind, this match is almost as good as solved because there's no way that Mateakui and Solarin can find any point to bring this score back. We see a miss from Mateakui. We're into the final quarter of the map. Nevermind is still holding on to the combo. It's either 400,000 lead and Celerant missing. With that, there's no chance that Goku or Team Goku can find any lead into this match. It is almost a solved done deal for the side of Game Enjoyers. And these last seconds is just a victory lap for them. As we say, GG, well played at every single person in this match. There were some very close songs. Points were going back and forth. We do see a miss from Nevermind, so he's not going to get that FC. But it doesn't matter at all. As he tries to spin to get that 900k that he gets. GG, well played to every person that was on the side of Team Goku and Team Game Enjoyers. With that, I don't believe there are any other matches for about an hour and a half. I know that there is one at 6 UTC, and then I think that is one of the final matches of the day, for me at least. But, you know, I'm going to be heading out. I'm a little tired, gonna take like a tiny nap and then come back for some repping, maybe some more commentary. Everybody have a good rest of your day, evening, night, morning, wherever you are. I hope to see you guys very, very soon. Have a good one.